Bay Street Theater lies at the heart of Sag Harbor's Main Street and waterfront. For 30 years, Bay Street has served as a professional regional theater and community center, and its mission extends to educating both children and adults alike in the performing arts. After 30 years, Bay Street continues to serve not only as the primary year-round revenue generator for this idyllic waterfront community, but it also serves over 30 other nonprofits and hundreds of artists each year.
But with time and success comes growth, and Bay Street Theater has long outgrown our current location. In our new facility, we'll be able to expand our new works programs to be presenting them all year round, bringing in writers and artists from our local communities, from around the country and around the world. We'll have expanded production capabilities in our wonderful new, still intimate 299-seat theater, which will allow us to do even more spectacular productions. And finally, we're bursting at the seams in terms of our education and community programs. We have expanded these programs, and we desperately need more space, and we will have a dedicated center for education and community programs for both kids and adults. There's so much that we will be able to achieve in this new space, so many new things we can bring to the community, and we can't wait to share them all with you.
We started in October of 2020 with the purchase of 22 Long Island Avenue, also known as West Water Street, a beautiful location bordering the new Steinbeck Park. We then retained Roger Ferris and Partners, a world-renowned architectural firm who has also worked extensively in the Hamptons from their Bridgehampton office location. With the village's help, we will build a beautiful building that fits into the character of the village, a building that will provide great public access and viewsheds to both the new Steinbeck Park and the waterfront beyond. Now, to take a tremendous project and make it even more historic for the village, we are also in current discussions to purchase number 2 Main Street. If we are successful in this acquisition, our intent is to remove the building, expand the park, and create unbelievable views down Main Street. This purchase would be solely for the overall benefit of Sag Harbor. If this deal goes through, we would be honored to provide this lasting amenity for our village and for generations to come. The Bay Street site has three forces at work. The first is the program itself, in which we create a 299-seat theater to replace the current one, and the theater will be the state of the art, which we have not had for 30 years. The problem for us is that theaters are typically windowless volumes, and any state of the art theater requires ancillary spaces, such as a fly loft, which by nature is tall. Though in our case, it will be much lower than the building it is next door to. The second force is the site itself, which is long and narrow. It is wedged between the new waterfront park and a major thorough street. The building will need to respond to each equally. The site is also the gateway to the northernmost edge of the village. The third force is that there are existing regulations as well as new regulations that will be put in place for the waterfront district. All of these will be considered to bring a new civic structure to the village that will function as a public amenity. The current site contains the 7-Eleven building. The new waterfront park is to the north, the John Steinbeck Park, newly designed. The building on the end, 2 Main Street, sits on the corner. This is the gateway currently of the north end of Sag Harbor and has been for decades. Now we have an opportunity to change the whole northern entry into the village. In terms of the architectural design, the building is pushed to the west, away from the intersection, so it is nestled in the landscape of the park. It offers a direct connection to the park through plazas on the east and west sides of the building. The plazas open up visual connections from the street to the water. The plazas also grant entry to the building. The design strategy begins with a double gabled form that is referential to familiar shingle style architecture common throughout Sag Harbor and the Hamptons. The twin gables camouflage the fly loft, the biggest challenge, while reducing the scale of the massing, bringing the edges down to pedestrian level. The theater is organized to allow circulation at the perimeter. It's a building within a building. The transparency of the exterior walls allows a connection from outside to inside and activates the street. Both warm and inviting wood lattice window systems are contained in the zinc gable form. This evokes craft, an assemblage of parts, referencing the industrial history of Sag Harbor. We are extremely excited about this design for Sag Harbor, for Bay Street, and for all of our constituents. We look forward to sharing more exciting news with you soon. Thank you for watching.